Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ranganathan. In a heart-throbbing incident in which a lady doctor allegedly committed suicide after killing her husband and two children at their house in Om Nagar area of Koradi police station. The woman was a medical practitioner while the husband was professor at an engineering college. The incident has sent shockwave in the city that is already struggling with the rising coronavirus pandemic cases. The deceased have been identified as a Dheeraj Digambar Rane, HOD of Computer Science at GH Raisun Institute of Information and Technology. Dr. Sushma Rane working with Avanti Hospital, Dhruv Rane and Vanya Rane all residing at Om Nagar Koradi. In a preliminary probe, it suggested that Dr. Sushma allegedly killed her husband and the children by injecting unidentified medicine and then ended her life. All the suspense released when Supreme Court allowed CBI investigation in Sushant Singh Rajput's death. A single judge bench of Justice Rishikesh Roy has pronounced the verdict in Riya Chakravarti's plea on August 11 after hearing, which lasted over 3 hours. The Supreme Court of India has allowed the CBI to investigate the death case of actor Sushant Singh Rajput. The top court today asked the Mumbai police to hand over all evidence collected so far to the investigating agency. The court also said the FIR registered in Bihar based on the complaint filed by Sushant Singh's father was correct and Bihar was competent to ask the CBI to investigate the case. A number of Bollywood celebrities had sought a CBI investigation into the death of 34-year-old actor. Ravindra Thakre, district collector, has given approval to designate 4 hospitals in a rural area of district as a dedicated COVID hospitals, a move to ensure the COVID-19 patient in a rural area of the district get immediate medical care. These 4 hospitals, including Lifeline Hospital, Ayushman Hospital and Asha Hospital in Kamti and Archangel Hospital in Umret. All the required facilities, including oxygen supply, etc., will be provided to COVID-19 patients at these hospitals. A very well-admired and famous festival, Pola, always witnesses Marbat procession on the occasion of Pola every year. The historical Marbat festival of Central India, also known as Kali Pili Marbat, celebrated every year with a great zeal and high spirit. Started during the British rule in the year 1885 to protest against the British, the Marbat procession is unique and is celebrated only in Nagpur city and is a major attraction at the end of the holy month of Shravan. Small dolls out in procession on the second day of Pola. These dolls would be representative of all the diseases and evil spirit that people believe fostered them. Due to pandemic situation under COVID-19, this year the procession and celebration of Marbat festival suspended at the starting point itself. On the occasion, worship of Marbat were performed and prayer were made to set the country free from corona and safeguard of the society. As we know, the nation is undergoing a difficult situation after the outbreak of COVID-19 and COVID patients are being treated only in 9 private hospitals of Nagpur, which has a population of 35 lakhs. The shocking thing here is that in many of the hospitals among them, COVID patients are not being admitted without depositing Rs 50,000 to Rs 2 lakh in advance. This raises the question whether private hospitals are being monitored with regard to government rates or not. On the other hand, the hospital's administration said that after treatment, the patients are creating trouble to pay the hospital fees, so advance is being taken. If the government takes responsibility for the cost of treatment, then we will not take advance. The rapid increase in the positive cases in the city has also created a situation of fear. On the one hand, no one is willing to go to May Hospital or government medical college and hospitals due to the rising number of cases in the city. While on the other hand, the beds reserved for COVID patients are full in the private hospitals. Therefore, even if the patient with moderate and severe symptoms of COVID get a bed in a private hospital, then they have to deposit an advance of Rs 50,000 to Rs 2 lakh. The patient who have health insurance card covering several lakhs also have to deposit this advance. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, please stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please do take good care of yourself.